So today we're going to be tying a simple scud pattern. I'm going to be starting off with just a few wraps of 0.015 millimeter lead-free wire, just to give it some weight, because this is a fly that you want to fish at the bottom where the fish will be feeding. And today I'm using a size 14 scud hook, one of my favorite sizes to tie scuds on. So after getting the lead wire wrapped on, we're going to want to push it back away from the eye a little bit so we can start our thread. I'm using olive Danville thread here. Trim off the waist. Then we're going to go ahead and lock down those lead wraps with the thread. Just go ahead and make wraps to cover that up. Next, we're going to add on a few fibers from a hackle, and just to create a little tail here. So I took about 10 or so fibers, slight brown orange color, and put them on up near the eye of the hook. And to keep them away from the eye so you can tie in your fly line, I'm just going to take a few wraps on the other side next to the eye. Just a few wraps to prop up those fibers a little bit, just like that. Next, we're going to take some silver ultra wire and tie in, which will be used later on as the ribbing to give the scud some segmentation. Go ahead and wrap that back down into the bend of the hook. Next, for the exoskeleton of the scud, we're going to tie in here some clear thin skin. Besides clear, there's a lot of different patterned thin skin that also look really nice. But we're just going to wrap that back again to the end of the hook and then start adding our dubbing. I'm using an olive colored sow scud dummy. We're going to start at the back and work our way to the middle, building up the body as we work towards the middle. One thing I am going to add in today, besides this green olive color, some dark orange dubbing as well. That may either act kind of like a hot spot, or from what I've read, pink as well as orange are often used when tying scuds, as they can represent, from what I've read, pink, pregnant scud, and orange often may be a dead scud. finish it off with all the dubbing, wrap it back towards the eye of the hook, grab the thin skein, bring it over the top, and tie that down with a few loops of thread. Make sure it's centered there on the back, and to keep it from mashing down the tail, I'm just going to pull it back and take another few wraps to keep it pointed in that direction. Then clip off the excess. Now that we've got that tied down, we can grab a hold of our silver wire and begin making even wraps up along the body to form the different segmentation in the exoskeleton or in the thin skin. Another thing you could try doing here is before making the wraps with your wire, you could use a Velcro brush at this time to pull out some of that dubbing to form the appendages. In this case, I'm going to wait till after wrapping, but sometimes it can be easier if you do it before wrapping the silver wire. So after I got that wire up back up to the eye, just took a few wraps to tie it down and then helicoptered the wire to break it off. All I've left is to do a quick whip finish. And we're almost done. Go ahead and trim those tail a little bit. I'm going to take that piece of Velcro, start working underneath on that dubbing to pull out some of that dubbing to represent the legs of the skin. Now that we have that pulled out, I'm going to go ahead and just trim them up, even with the hook. And here we have our finished scud.